Hey everybody, welcome to Making Australia the Crafter Show, where we're going to be recapping every episode of this season of Making Australia. I'm crochet artist Chilly Philly, and every week I'm joined by a new fun crafty guest. And for today, I'm joined by carpenter and rival brawn Simon Mee. Woo!
Hello, how are you, Chilly Philly? What's going on?
So obviously, you know, people know you from Survivor, but I just introduced you as a chippy. What sort of brought you to sort of being a carpenter and all that sort of stuff?
Yeah, well, I think like, you know, I was obviously on the Brawn tribe on Survivor, but like I think there's another side of me that not a lot of people know about. Like I'm probably a bit of a nerd when it comes to some other things. But I worked in an office job in marketing for 10 years behind a computer, and I stepped away from that world, and I now am an apprentice carpenter. And what I'm doing for a living is working with my hands, building things, creating things. And that level of job satisfaction that you get at the end of the day when you look back and go, wow, I built that. That's really special, and I am not looking back.
This week is all about playing. And so for the faster craft, the makers were asked to make their own instrument. Who were your favorites in this challenge?
Ooh, all right. So my top three from that challenge would have to be Jax Jaquette. I love that idea, and seeing that come to life was super impressive. Yeah. Look, I did really like Will's harp, just seeing him craft what he loves out of woodwork. Like, I'm a real sucker for that.
My favorite.
big points for me there. And I really like Rosaldi's, I can't even remember the name of that instrument, but that was really impressive. Like seeing how well crafted and the attention to detail that went into that build in such a short amount of time. Yeah, that was so cool. And then seeing him play at the end and the passion that went into it, like that's really special.
Yeah.
And the other one for me would have to be George's kalimba.
Yeah.
I love, like that was just so impressive to see how just functional and well finished that was in such a short period of time. Like they're the kind of things that really blow me away when you can see what these artists can achieve in such a short amount of time. And the attention to detail around it, and you know, everything down to the painting, you know, as well as the sound there, you go, wow, that's not only really well thought out, but that looks like a well finished piece. And yeah, you know, that kind of creates that real wow moment. So yeah, that's a real winner for me as well.
And for the Mastercraft, the challenge was to make a game. So it had to be a functional game, you know, had to have its own rules, but it also had to not be something that already existed. Who did you like? Because we had such a range. Who did you like the best out of all of those?
So there were a couple for me. Rihanna had the best in her pizza. Was it pizza time?
Yes, I think it was pizza time, because then you were like, pizza time. Jump on the,
but I loved, like, you know, that was just such a fun concept. Oh, look, the other one for me, as soon as Rosaldi pulled out the tin of Milo and emptied that onto the game and all those little cups of jelly, I was like,
yeah,
this game is going to be a real winner there.
Yeah.
that was a lot of fun.
Yeah, yeah. I was actually pretty scared though when they started trying to play it and seeing how, like trying to stick the pieces on top of it. Like, I think you said that's definitely like an ankle breaker. Like that's definitely a dangerous game. But it definitely, I think out of most of them, it definitely had the most sort of fun. Like, yeah, I don't know. There was something a little bit more adventurous with it that I think a lot of the other ones didn't necessarily have. I think the other one that I really liked was George's, just because it was like essentially human battleship.
Yeah.
If you blew that up maybe three times the size, and so you could literally just go wherever, and then you did that, I think that would actually be such a fun game. Or even multiple people were able to, like, I think that had a lot of potential. So Rihanna wins the Mastercraft, which we both liked her game, but unfortunately Denise is the one who goes home, which I think if you look at the criteria that they were looking at, her game, whilst it was definitely an evolution of a pre-existing game, still relied on it being you know, a game that already existed.
Yeah, I would have liked to see, as the judges kind of mentioned, you know, what are the penalties for, you know, going through the holes, or just some kind of, you know, just extra little element there, because it looked so, you know, enticing with all the, you know, the abstract art all over it. And what are the implications of that? I think she could have brought that element to life a little bit more. Who are your picks from here? Who are you excited to see?
Okay, I think my top three right now would probably be George. She can make anything, really. And she's very resourceful with her materials. Rizaldi, for almost the same reason. They both have very good sort of refined skill sets, and really have been able to, you know, apply themselves to different challenges, use different materials, and they're very consistent with that. And then I think at this point, maybe Rahana's probably the third person in that. She's winning a lot of challenges at this point, and definitely has more of a craft sensibility that sort of edges her out amongst the rest as well, which I guess I appreciate. Who are you liking?
I am a real sucker for both Andrew and Will.
Will? Like
I just think, you know, I can't go past the, the tradesmen, I guess, but working with wood and metal, like, I want to see those guys do well. But I think this game is made for George. Like, she is a proven challenge beast.
Yes.
And I am excited to see what she comes out with next.
Yeah. Yeah. Who would have thought? Would be saying that George is a challenge beast.
Well played.
Well, thank you, Simon, so much for joining me today. It's actually been a lot of fun watching with you and getting all your thoughts.
Yes, thank you for having me. It's been an absolute pleasure to get involved and see what these amazing artists are pulling together. And yeah, looking forward to seeing the rest of the season play out.
Thank you, everybody, for watching this episode of The Crafter Show. Join me again next week for another Crafter Show. And until then, keep crafting. Bye.
Bye.